Today we're going to do a quick look at the develop module and sliders and switches. And if you'll notice here, I have an on-off switch on every one of my develop panels, except for the basic panel, which doesn't come with an on-off switch. So anything where you've done work, if you click the switch, you don't slide up or down, you just merely click on it. It will turn on that particular panel's changes. And here, you can see I've done some vignetting, and I can turn them on and off. So I can see what it looked like before and after. And if I'm unhappy with this, I can just simply double click on the title of this subpanel. This is a subpanel down here for grain. This is a subpanel here for post-crop vignetting. And if I double click on it, Lightroom resets the sliders to their default positions and to the default numbers, as if I had done nothing. And the same will hold true in the basic panel. I've done a lot of changes in here, and we have three subpanels: the white balance, tone, and presence. And when you double click on the white balance name, or WB in this case, you will reset the settings to the way your camera captured the original picture, or as shot. So it'll reset these settings to the way the camera captured your picture. On the tone here, in this panel, this subpanel, if I double click on tone, it will zero out all of these settings to the Lightroom defaults, which in this case is zero. Now if I press Command Z, I can restore those settings. I press Command Z to undo these, so I can also demonstrate another way to zero out settings. When I double-click the word tone in the tone panel here, it zeroes everything. But if I double-click the word exposure, it will zero out only the exposure. If I double-click the word contrast, exactly the same. Another way to do it is to double-click the actual slider. And double-clicking the slider will zero that out. So either double-clicking the name or double-clicking the slider will set the slider to its default position, or in this case, to zero. And this will hold true for every panel. No matter where you're working, double-clicking on the title of any of the sub-panels will set the sliders to the default positions, or a zero position. In this case, in sharpening, the default position are these particular numbers. And if I change them, and I double click sharpening, it will reset them to those default positions. And when you're working in something like the basic panel, where zero is your default setting, double clicking on the sub panel header or name will set those settings to zero. Now we're going to take a look at the local adjustment tools here, the adjustment bar. I'm going to close the effects panel here, and now we're going to take a look here at the adjustments. And you'll notice when you open up an adjustment tool, it pushes the other panels down so it can open up its own special panel. And in this particular case, again, this is a subpanel here, and this is a subpanel, and this is a subpanel. And when I double click the word effect, these will all zero out, just like that. So it works the same way as the panels do. And these panels all have an on-off switch as well. Those are down here. So there's your on-off switch. And this on-off switch will affect whatever I've done here. And this is a little bit of work I've done. And when I turn that on and off, I can see just the work I've done in this adjustment brush. And this reset button is not the same as resetting your sliders. Now, any of these sliders here can be reset by double-clicking the name or by double-clicking the slider. However, when I choose reset down here, it doesn't reset these sliders. What it does do is it undoes the work I've done in my canvas here, and this handwork that I've done that is opening up the shadow detail, if I press reset, it's going to throw away my work. So this is a button you want to use if you want to discard your work. These are sliders that you can reset to zero by double-clicking the word effect or double-clicking the names or sliders to reset a particular number. So reset deletes your work. The on-off switch shows you before and after by turning the effect of the tool on and off, and double-clicking a name or a slider will reset the slider to zero. So that's it on the basics for sliders and switches. This is Lightroom Guy. Thanks for watching.